From Addicted to Puzzles. Today I'm going to talk about my trip to Colorado to do the 60,000 piece puzzle in one day. So the big question is, did we do it in one day? And the answer is no, but that's okay. They did 45,000 pieces on a Saturday, which to me is a huge success. So there were 175 people that showed up throughout the day. Not everybody stayed for the full 14 hours that some people were there. I got there at 8:30 in the morning and I left at 9 o'clock at night. I had to drive back the next day, or I probably would have stayed. And I wish I would have stayed because they were done with the sections that were still going on, and they left at 10 o'clock. So it was only an extra hour. But with the time change that night and having to drive back the next day, I left at 9. So there were 175 people throughout the day. Some stayed all day, some only stayed a few hours. So the people that didn't stay all day, obviously they didn't finish their, if you were only there for 3 hours, they didn't finish their sections. So 45,000 pieces were completed. So 45 sections of the 60. So to me, that's incredibly amazing. There were 8 unopened bags and 7 sections that were partially completed. So on May 6th, they're going to be doing a part 2 to finish up the, it's really less than 15,000 pieces that they have left. So I'm hoping to be able to go. It's just really going to depend on my husband's work schedule if I can get out of town again. So I'm really hoping to be able to make it back to the second part. So I will put an invitation in the description to the part 2 on May 6th, and it's in Centennial, Colorado, which is on the southeast portion of Colorado, which I was thankful for because I drove up from Albuquerque. And it was about 6.5 hours, not a crazy, amount of driving time. It was probably more of a boring drive than anything until you hit Colorado Springs, and then the traffic started getting a little heavier. And by that time, I just wanted to get to Centennial and to my hotel room, because I'm not very good at with I'm just not good with traffic. I mean, I have GPS in my car. I've driven all over this country, but I'm not good with traffic anymore. So the drive wasn't too bad. And then, Sunday morning I drove back to Albuquerque. So I did section 42, which was largely the, it had some hot air balloon area. I don't remember what towns were in the bottom right corner, but it had some hot air balloons because I love hot air balloons. And then roughly 3/4 of the puzzle was Russia and Asia, the map area. And I chose a harder one because I've done the puzzle before. If you haven't watched my videos on it, I did the 60,000 piece puzzle from November 6th, I think, or 7th, 9th, 8th, I don't remember. It was the beginning of November, and I finished it on January 6th. So I did it in 57 days. So I wanted to choose a map area because I know people probably would look at, all that yellow on there and be like, I don't want to do that one. So I did a large map area. And then I finished it in, I don't know, it probably took me a good 5 or 6 hours to finish that day. That day. After I finished mine, finished up. I met a girl that I follow on Instagram. Her name is Erin, and her Instagram is Puzzle Exchange. I think Puzzle underscore Exchange on Instagram. I finished up her section, which was section 32, and it was largely a map of Europe. She had to leave a little early to, tend to her animals and stuff like that. So I was like, I'll finish your section for you. And we were talking before she left. We should have swapped puzzles. After a couple hours, because then it would have been fresh eyes on a new puzzle and we might have actually got them both done quicker. So I chose section 42 because of the map area, but I also chose 42 because when I was in kindergarten in Southern California, we went to the San Diego Zoo when I was in kindergarten, and my bus number was 42, and we had to march around the zoo going 42, 42, so we didn't forget our bus number. And 45 years later, I still have not forgot my bus number from that trip to the San Diego Zoo in kindergarten. So 42 is just a number that I like. Okay, so this t-shirt is Team 60,000, the Puzzler's Bazaar. If you don't follow them on Instagram, they have Team 1,000, 2,000 shirts, I think Team 500, but they made the Team 60,000 when I finished the 60,000 piece puzzle. Thank you, Puzzler's Bazaar. If you've done the 60,000 piece puzzle and you want a Team 60,000 t-shirt, so everybody in Colorado should go get one of these shirts. They also have a mug and they also have a hoodie. And I'll put a link to the description for all the products that they have for the Team 60,000. Erin at the Puzzle Exchange, she runs a website called The Puzzle Exchange, or I think it's just puzzleexchange.com. But what she does is she makes, she doesn't make anything. She rents or sells puzzles. So if you have like a small apartment and you don't have room for a puzzle room, you can actually rent puzzles. And this would have been something I completely would have used when I was younger because I used to just puzzle on my coffee table. I used to take my puzzles because I didn't have a lot of room. So I would take the puzzles out of the box and just put them in a baggie. Sometimes I saved the picture. Sometimes I didn't. So I have some storage bins in my closet that just have 1,000 or 2,000 puzzle pieces. Some are 500s, but I don't know what they are because I threw the pictures away. So I have a bunch of mystery puzzles in my closet that I'll get to one day. I already put them together. I think a lot of them are like Big Ben puzzles, puzzles that are from like, the maybe late 90s and early 2000s. I don't have the pictures for a lot of them, which will be fun when I actually put them together one day. But the Puzzle Exchange, you can rent puzzles, and you can buy puzzles. So, like I said, if you don't have a lot of space, if you're just in like a one bedroom apartment, or you just puzzle on your coffee table and have a stack against your wall, look up the Puzzle Exchange because she has, I believe she said, over 5,000 puzzles to choose from, which is an extraordinary amount of puzzles to be able, I mean, it's a humongous shop. So definitely, I'll put her website in the description so you can check out some of her rentals. And also, she makes earrings. I don't know if they're for sale on her website, but she's making me a fabulous pair of earrings, and I should be getting them any day. So when I get them and I do another video, I'll show you the earrings that she got me. But I'm also going to post them on Instagram and Facebook, so be on the lookout for that. Super nice people. Erin was super sweet. Emily that put it together, she was amazing. Like, she coordinated this whole event. Her husband would take the completed sections and sandwich them into cardboard and make sure they were, flat and secure so that nothing would happen to them. Just a wonderful group of people. I met so many fun people that day. They had pizza for lunch, which was delicious. So thank you, pizza guy. It was some of the best pizza I think I've ever had. And then, yeah, just a really good group of people. I'm hoping to be able to go back because, that way I can maybe instead of puzzling for 13 hours, we'll actually be able to like hang out, maybe go to dinner or something. Because the rest of the people that were left, none of us ate dinner. And by the time I got back to the hotel, it was just too late. So I was like, whatever. But I know that there was quite a handful of us that, we puzzled or they skipped dinner. It was a lot of fun. So if you're near Denver or you want to fly to Denver and do 15,000 help out with the last 15,000 pieces. I know they would appreciate the help. And it was just a lot of fun. And Emily was super sweet, and she got me a gift for showing up. This is Something's Amiss by Puzzle Twist, and it's called International, I'm sorry, Intentional Kindness. This puzzle is what's on the box isn't quite what the puzzle is when you put it together. So that's why it's a puzzle twist. Emily got this for me. It's one of the puzzles that they did for speed puzzling competitions. And I saw this puzzle on Karen Puzzle's Instagram, I believe when she went to Minnesota to do the speed puzzling, and I believe this is the one that they did there. So I'm super excited to do this puzzle. I have three puzzles that I'm going to speed puzzle. This one for sure. I have another one from Donna Louise that I'm going to send to her after I speed puzzle it. It's the San Diego 500 piece puzzle that they did in September for their speed puzzling competition, the USA Puzzle Association. And then I have a 500 piece Ravensburger puzzle called Kitty in a Teacup, I think. Kitty in a Cup. May 6th, Centennial, Colorado. I'll put the invite in the description. And I know that they will get the puzzle completed on that day, so I'm hoping to be able to make it. And thank you, Emily, for organizing such an incredible event. And it was a lot of fun. For Pi Day, because Pi Day was on Tuesday, I did the maths puzzle from Magnolia. It's 1,000 pieces, and it's just a bunch of math problems, honestly. I was going fairly quick when I was doing like all the reds and the blues and the greens and the yellows. And then I hit all the whites, and then I just came to this brick wall. This puzzle took me a total of 9.5 hours. And okay, something else. So I usually puzzle from the box. I dig through the box, I take out the pieces I need, I put them in so that I have a nice, fairly organized and clean puzzle area. When I was in Colorado, I noticed the majority of people dump the pieces out and they have them all flipped up. And I've seen, pictures all over Facebook and Instagram of, dumping the pieces out. And I do that when I speed puzzle with a 500 piece puzzle. I'll just dump the pieces out and go for it. I've never done it with a 1,000 piece puzzle though. So when I did this math puzzle, I dumped all the pieces out. And it worked out perfect because with this type of puzzle, it 100% helped to be able to see all the pieces. I'm gonna try it again on a maybe a little more busier puzzle. Dump the pieces out and see how I like it. I kind of like it. I don't know if it's something I would do with every puzzle. I definitely wouldn't do it with like 1,000 or like a 2,000 piece puzzle because that would just be too many pieces for me. But it worked so perfect with this maths puzzle. I don't know if I would have did it any quicker puzzling out of the box. I think it helped a ton though to have all the pieces. So I won't, because everybody puzzles different. I like a cleaner work area. Having all the pieces out, I think, with certain puzzles is super helpful. So this was the maths puzzle. Yesterday, I did the 60th anniversary of the Springbok company, and this is the puzzler. So this is the second puzzle that Springbok has released. I did this one in 5 hours. A 500 piece puzzle. And again, I just dumped the pieces out. And with this one, it worked perfect because you need to be able to see all the different shapes and stuff. So it worked phenomenal. And like I said, I do that when I speed puzzle. And I didn't really start speed puzzling until last year. And I think speed puzzling is a blast. But this one, obviously, I wasn't speed puzzling, but it was super helpful to be able to have all the pieces out. So this is the 60th anniversary for Springbok. And it's crazy because I've been buying Springboks, I guess, since the 80s. So they were still a fairly young company in the 80s. I guess, yeah, they were a fairly younger company in the 80s. I didn't realize that. This one doesn't pass a pickup challenge or anything. It's fairly loose. They're puzzles from the 80s. I mean, if it was a 2000 piece puzzle, you can pick it up perfectly. This one's not quite like that. The pieces aren't as thick and, snug as they used to be. But the color is beautiful. The piece shapes were really fun. It's just all the abstract piece shapes. I enjoyed it. I would love to be able to do the original one without the 60 because I feel like, having all this made it quite a bit easier. So the original one I know would be quite a bit harder. But I loved it. I had a blast. So that was 5 hours. This one was 9.5. And this one will pa pass a pickup challenge. This one's by Magnolia, and I have more Magnolia puzzles that I'm really looking forward to doing. Oh, that was bad. I just put it down wrong. This one's gonna hang in my son's room because he loves math and he really enjoyed it. I think he helped out just a tiny bit. My husband helped out a little bit too toward the end. My husband would take a piece and find it on the box and then just put it in. I will look at the box for 5 minutes looking for, like say, like I was looking for this triangle piece. I'll never find it. I don't know what it is about me looking at the box, but when I'm looking for a specific thing on a box, I can't find it. I don't know why. I'll stare at the box and I'll be as careful as I can looking, and I just won't find exactly what I'm looking for. So my husband kind of amazes me when he can just find something so quickly on the box, and I'm looking for, 5 minutes and I can't find it. I think it's kind of a little bit of a gift that he has, maybe more attention to detail. I'm not really sure. But it's funny how he does that. Another puzzle I did recently, and I shouldn't have put it away because I wanted to actually show it to you. But I'll do a little short so that you can see the details of it. So be looking for a short on it. I don't know if you can see it. This is a topographic view of Mount Everest. And it's by Gemtert. And it was only 300 pieces. And it has all the beautiful little squiggly pieces that I love. So much. I love these little squiggly pieces. They just remind me of little people. I don't know. They're so fun. Love the pieces. This is probably my favorite brand. They're super challenging. I have another one that I'll show you. Oh, well, anyway, before I show you that one, topographic view of Mount Everest. And it was only 300 pieces. And it took me 7.5 hours. So that's how crazy hard this puzzle was. Not all their puzzles are that super crazy hard. But this one, obviously, it was just black and white, or really kind of black and bluish purple is what the lines were. 7.5 hours. Not all in one sitting. I actually just put it together when I was watching TV. I have yet to really, they're harder ones to do them. I have yet to do one of their harder ones in one sitting, but that is going to change because this one, which is the Mariana Trench topographic view, I'm going to do this in one sitting. Maybe. Well, it depends how long it takes me, actually. If it takes me 10 hours, it probably won't be in one sitting. And then there's, their impossible puzzle, which is they're clear They're the super cool squiggly pieces, but they're acrylic. So you don't know which is up and which is down. And it always comes with a top. So this one, I'm going to do in one sitting and I'm going to time myself with it. So the Mariana Trench and this impossible magma puzzle, I'm definitely going to time myself and do it in one sitting. I mean, maybe two sittings. It just depends how long it takes me, because sometimes I don't always have the option to sit in here for, 10 hours and puzzle. Usually it's like 5 or 6. And then, okay, so I'm going to do this next week, okay? This is the all red puzzle from Blue Kazoo. This one is only 250 pieces. I have the 1,000-piece puzzle, but I'm gonna do a challenge with this 250-piece one and the impossible magma, which is 240 pieces. I'm gonna time myself on both of them and I'm gonna see which one took longer and which one was harder. So, this is just a normal grid cut, all red puzzle. This is the cool acrylic, I don't know which side is up or down, with squiggly pieces by Gem Turt, and it's called Magma. So, in the comments, please tell me which one you think will be harder and which one will take longer. And I'm going to put these together. Again, it might not be in one sitting, but it will be time-lapsed and timed. And I'm actually going to try to do these next week. And I know I've talked about it before, but it has to happen. I have to do these. So let me know which one you think will be harder, which one you think will take the longest. I'm going to do the double-sided puzzles. I have a Mickey, Disney villains. I might even do my little leprechauns again, the double-sided Disney puzzles. Or the double-sided puzzles by Buffalo Games, because I really want to do, there's a whole bunch of those that I want to do also. So those are some things that I've been talking about for probably the past month, and they're finally going to happen. And then probably the week after Easter, because Easter, I have some Easter puzzles and some gradient puzzles I want to do for that week before Easter. I'm going to start the 40,000 piece Mickey through the years puzzle after Easter in April, because that is the one that won the vote. So be on the lookout for that. And I don't know if I'm gonna do like section, 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 and just bang it out, or if I'll do like a section and then another puzzle. But I will definitely be doing it. I'll talk about it. I'll be time-lapsing the entire thing because I love watching a huge puzzle time-lapse come together. They're so much fun. I think that's it for this video. So, puzzleexchange.com, if you are wanting or needing to rent puzzles, please check out her selection and I'll have a discount code in the description along with her website. Let me know which one of these puzzles you think will be harder to do, and I will be doing these next week. And I'll be doing the speed challenge puzzles next week because I think those will be quite fast. So I'm going to do a puzzle haul pretty soon, and I'm also going to be going over the craft night puzzle with A Killing Affair. Someone had requested that, so I'm going to do a review on what I thought about that puzzle. I'll have links in the description for the Puzzle Exchange, the Evite to the 60,000 piece part two puzzle build, and I'll put a link in there for my build of the 60,000 piece puzzle on my playlist. I'm at 3,900 and something subscribers right now, so when I hit 4,000 subscribers, I'll be doing this puzzle by Pintu. It's 4,000 pieces. It's called 160 Cats, I believe. And I know it's in four sections because they put their puzzles into sections, but I am going to be mixing the whole thing together as a 4,000 subscriber special video. So, and I know the Pintu puzzles are so fantastic. I'll be able to just pick it up, lift it. All the pieces are kind of small. I don't think it's going to be too hard to mix it since it's a gradient, and that's kind of why I chose it, because I really like, I like the rainbow gradients. So I have less than 100 subscribers. Share, subscribe, that way I can hurry up and get to 4,000 subscribers so I can do this puzzle by Pintu. It's gonna be amazing. All right, so a lot coming up. Very excited for all these things coming up. So make sure you subscribe, like my video, share them if you want. I don't mind at all. That's it. So I'll see you in the next video and happy puzzling. Bye, guys. Bye, everybody.